Welcome back, and Leanne, you're absolutely right. Just taking a look at the new logo, it really is very striking and very powerful, especially when you get it from a different perspective. And we should show our listeners a little bit more about that. But first, though, shockingly, in the past year alone, the Gauteng Department of Education has received 175 complaints of physical assault of pupils by teachers. 118 of these cases have ended in guilty verdicts. And in addition to the department, the department has seen 43 complaints of sexual abuse by teachers, and that resulted in 19 guilty verdicts. And this is according to our next guest, the Gauteng MEC Panyaza Lesufi, whom we welcome now. MEC Lesufi, always good to speak to you, but of course these are not the best of circumstances, rather worrying statistics that we are looking at here.
Good morning, Sakina, and welcome to the new show.
Thank you.
No, it's indeed, it's a disturbing trend, but what makes us to feel much better is that we've got the systems to track it. The mere fact that we can give you the statistics, the mere fact that we can identify the culprits, and the mere fact that we can act, and also we can hand over some of the suspects to the law enforcement agencies, is enough information that our system can identify and deal with the problem. Indeed, the numbers are huge, but you know, we live in a violent society, and schools are not immune from that situation. And therefore, some of the problems that we see within the schooling environment are some of the shocking problems that we're seeing outside the schooling environment. I mean, you know, the number of gender violence that we witness in society, and the violence, you go to our hospitals over the weekends, it's too much violence. But we just met all the SGBs, and we've given them a strict instructions. Our approach is very simple. There must be what we say is learner dignity. Every learner must feel safe, protected, and given the necessary education that will make them to survive.
I think you make a fair point, MEC, looking at the broader socioeconomic issues and how that impacts on our schools. Yeah. However, I think it is scant comfort when one thinks about the fact that corporal punishment was abolished in our schools in 1997. Yeah. That's 21 years ago. And for some or other reason, our teachers are still engaging in acts of corporal punishment.
And the good thing is that they know that it's a dismissible offense. They also know that the state has strengthened the hand, that we encourage parents as well to lay a charge of assault so that that particular teacher is not an issue only of losing a job, but you can also face criminal charges outside the schooling environment. So our approach is very simple. We are merciless on this particular matter. We'll act decisively. We've got the capability, the talent, and the skill to preside over these cases, and we can be in a position to arrest the situation as quickly as possible. The numbers are huge because we can be in a position to identify the culprit.
How many teachers have you dismissed in
44.
The last year alone?
44.
44, but you found 118 of them guilty. So what about the rest?
Well, some of the issues are justified, to be quite frank. What do you do to a teacher that is attacked by learners? That teacher must be a sitting duck and be attacked. That teacher has the right to defend himself. And if he defend himself or herself and he present that side of the case in our hearings, you can't be blind to that issue. You have to be very sympathetic. The issue, as I can, is that if we can allow teachers to lose control of the classroom, then we don't have an education system. We need to protect the educators, but within the parameters of the law. We have to ensure that those learners that are violent, we provide the relevant relief that they need. Either we expel them from the school, or we place them within the rehabilitation center so that they can get a better new lease of life, so that when they come back within the schooling environment, they can behave appropriately. It's a huge balancing act that we need to carry on at all times. We don't have to be emotional about it, but we have to act where we believe we need to protect not only the learners, but also our teaching staff.
Teachers applying corporal punishment, learners attacking teachers, two sides of the same coin, which speaks to a discipline issue generally in our schools, or a lack thereof. But what has the department done in order to ensure that they better capacitate and empower teachers to deal better with issues of discipline?
The opposite is true, Sakina. We've got 2.3 million learners in our education system. If only attended to almost less than 150 learners. We've got almost 68,000 educators in our province. We're talking about less than 200 educators. So reality is that majority of our educators are well behaved. Our majority of our learners are well behaved as well. But those that are misbehaving, we can't hide behind the broomstick and say they're few. We need to attend to it, deal with it, and ensure that we demonstrate our ability to discipline this kind of conduct and ensure that our schools are as safe as possible. But remember, we are an education system. We are not the law enforcement agencies. And that's why I argue with law enforcement agencies that you can't monitor taverns more at night and fail to monitor schools during the day. It's very important that schools be part of the law enforcement agencies when they patrol and when they attend to agent matters. If a school say there's somebody that is misbehaving, the nearest police station must know. We must drop everything and go to that particular school, because schools must be a center that all of us can claim to be safe.
And sexual abuse perpetrated by teachers, what has been your experience again over the last year?
That's a big no, Sakina. That is a big no. The mere fact that we've handed them over to the South African Council of Educators means that they're not going to practice anywhere in our country. The mere fact that we've handed over to the law enforcement agencies, it means they'll spend time in prison. And the mere fact that as a department, we've now started to revamp our reporting mechanism, because we don't want the incident to happen first and we act. Now we've appointed each and every school, have appointed a teacher that becomes a reporting mechanism, so that when that teacher starts to trouble the learner can report to the teacher and the teacher will be in a position to report to us, and we can bring the NGOs and law enforcement agencies. We believe now we've got a firm reporting mechanism that will assist us to deal with all these matters.
Last week, we ended an interview with the Deputy Minister of Justice that revealed something quite disturbing with regard to the sexual offenders register, and it indicated that only people who had molested children or had been found guilty on those charges were on that register, but people who had been convicted of rape generally of adults were not on that register, so they could still make their way into our schools as educators. Is that something that you will be pursuing?
That register needs a complete overhaul. From where we stand as an education system, we really believe that gaps that need to be closed as soon as possible. For example, if somebody has not gone through the justice system of court appearance and other thing, we dismiss through a disciplinary hearing, that particular name is not automatically in the register. We must be compelled that even if you have not gone through the justice system, the mere fact that you are at an ECD center and we found guilty of some of these particular horrendous deeds and we have been dismissed, it must be automatic that must also be reported in that register. So we've raised the alarm, and our national minister is leading us on this particular matter, and we are quite convinced that this particular matter will be appropriately attended.
MEC Panyaza Lesufi, thank you so much for speaking to us this morning. The Gauteng MEC for Education talking to us about the department's physical and sexual abuse complaints against